Yeah, well, we're now learning that the FBI used drones, likely provided from the U.S. military, to keep around-the-clock surveillance on that particular bunker. That's coming from former FBI official Tom Fuentes, who's been talking with his sources. But really, the future and what the FBI may be able to do down the line goes way beyond what was done here.
A little boy barricaded in a bunker with a killer. As the crisis stretched into a seventh day, an FBI hostage rescue team practiced how to save him. Law enforcement sources now say the FBI built a mock-up of the bunker and trained on how they'd go in. But how would they know what was happening below? A law enforcement source tells CNN authorities managed to slip a camera into the hideout.
They're going to try to introduce microphones and fiber optic lenses into a location like that.
But in the near future, federal agents and local police may have undetectable drones that can drive, fly, or swim into nearly any environment.
There may be as many as 30,000 unmanned vehicles in the air.
Professor Nathan Bush says designers are modeling the newest drones on nature.
So, you know, mimicking the actions of insects, the way that they crawl, for example, or fly.
They may be so small and agile, the drones could access tight spaces impossible for police to get to today. When the Army was funding research into small robotic birds, we got a good look at each other.
Right now, the hummingbird can only fly a little bit longer than 10 minutes. But at that size, imagine what it could do in 10 hours.
And it could fly through small clearings and through trees and see inside.
And if one crashes or the camera fails, developers at the University of Pennsylvania already have drones flying in synchronized formations. In the hostage crises of the future, it could give police a swarm of available replacements.